Here is a perplexing issue of Seaman. This is issue 44. It's the start of a new run on the book by Anne Master Herdling. But I very much doubt when people see this comic and they see this cover, what they expect is just a retelling of Rime of the Ancient Mariner, but with Seaman forced into it. This is a really bamboozling issue. I've no idea why it exists, but I do suspect that it was definitely not intended as a standard issue, because every page, almost every page, that one's not. Every page is like a splash page, it's like a portfolio sort of thing. So I suspect this was some rubbish that they commissioned for Marvel Funfair. This one, it's hard to follow because it's almost a straight adaptation of a poem. But it does try and find ways to make it a bit superhero-y. Like, we've got this character here, Albatross, Villian, I think. It's really not a poem that lends itself well to a conventional narrator. I actually thought of an amazing comparison, though. This is the most accurate comparison you will hear all day. This issue of Seaman, it is like, do you remember that one Simpsons episode, the first Halloween special, where they just do a really, really shit remake of The Raven? And it's just like a weird tonal shift and it doesn't work at all. And it's just deadly serious and they barely even try and insert jokes into it. This is that. This is flat out that. Except I actually did laugh at this once, which is more than I did at that Simpsons. Like, I didn't think an average comic book reader would have the interest or the patience for this. It's incredibly hard to follow without familiarity to the source material. There's scant dialogue. It's mostly all just a flat repeat of the original poem. But what happens is Seaman, he kills this fella. There is a little bit of ingenuity in how they have taken the albatross from the poem and they have made it into like a supervillain or a superhero. But this just needs a little more writing to it. And Master Herdling, he needed to expand on stuff rather than let the poem speak for itself. Even in this weird, twisted version that I'm pretty confident to say that the majority of readers buying this comic in the 90s would not have any awareness of. The basis of this as well seems to be entirely resting on the pun title. They've taken Rime of the Ancient Mariner and they've changed it to Rime of the Ancient Seaman. Yeah, it's a shit pun. Seaman, it don't sound anything like Mariner. It would work if his name was like Sea Mariner or Super Mariner or Summit. Also, this story probably isn't canon. It's like a fairy tale, so I didn't think there's much need to read this one. But you should know, if you skip this one and start with issue 45, a good issue, where the run technically really begins, you will be missing out on a fucking pirate Phanias. This is the bit that really made me laugh, by the way. If you didn't know what it's about, the poem, it's a bloke, he senselessly kills a bird, an albatross, and then his life gets shit because of all the guilt, so he repents. That's right, we've got fucking eyebrow literary analysis on this motherfucking channel nowadays. Look at that, that's a funny face. There is a miscoloured Satan, and I've no idea who this comic appeals to. If you're mad into Samuel Taylor Coleridge, you're probably not reading comics. There's more artful ways to adapt something than just copy and pasting the original text and changing the illustrations. There are some parts of this that really work. I think like some of the more mercenary and the barbaric things, they work well with Seaman, but it isn't a good read. Maybe if you're really into weird one-note genre fusions and are very familiar with both really long poems from the 16th century and also Marvel Comics continuity relating to Seaman and his mythology, then I think this might just be your favourite comic. I recommend this run and Master Erdlin's run, but I imagine this first issue would turn a lot of people off, so I can only give this one a 7 thumbs up.